All right, for part B here, we have a new startup file for you. So hopefully you've grabbed this file and you can check out what we're doing. What we're going to do this time is use random values, but we're not going to necessarily use them in the step event. We're just going to use them to show you that you can choose what kind of code you do. So before we use the random variable to decide if we are going to fire or if we are going to move, here we're going to use it to choose, do this or do that. So first example I'm going to do is I'm going to take the player, which right now can fire with the space bar. And I'm going to change this a bit. They fire an arrow right now. What I'm going to do instead is I'm going to use it, and I'm going to decide, should I fire a burger or should I fire an arrow? And it sounds a little weird, but the burger's there waiting to be used. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go a little bit above here. This is two choices. Really, it's this one or that one, and if I want it to be a nice 50-50 spread, I really only have to find two random numbers here. So I'm going to do this. Pick. Just making up a name there. Pick is I random range. Pick a number from 1 to 2. And then I'm going to ask if pick is 1, do this code. So if the number picked is a 1, it's going to be the arrow that's generated. Now, of course, you're saying, well, what happens if it's a number 2? If it's a number 2, well, I'm going to have another if statement afterwards. If the pick is 2, and we can just copy and paste all that code. It's basically going to be the same. The only difference is, and you probably know, is instead of making an arrow, we can do object burger. Now, whether we fire the arrow or we fire the burger, we're still going to be playing a sound. And so we can leave the sound out there. All right, sound's being played either way. Same sound for both. Now, if we test it out, remember it is random. Sometimes you get burger, sometimes you get arrow. So it looks like it's working okay. Now I'm going to give you a little addition to this code later on. If it seems like a lot of code to do that, you're right. There is a way we can shorten it. But for now, for beginner, that's pretty good. We'll do a little follow-up how to make this a little more efficient later on. Okay, so that was number one. The second thing we wanted to add to the program is to move the player to a random spot on the map of three specific spots when I click the mouse on them. So we'll go to the player. This is actually going to be a new event for us. Add mouse. And when you click on the player, you can use left pressed or right pressed. Okay, we'll do the left button being pressed down. And we'll add a little bit of code in there. Now I want the player to jump randomly to one of three spots. So since the choice here, and let's say I want to make them all equal options, I can just do some sort of number here. So num equals I random range 1 to 3. And now I can just ask some if statements. If num is 1, let's say x is 100, y is 100. If num is 2, x equals 200, y equals 200. I'm just making up these three locations here just to be quick. And if the number is 3, x equals 300, y equals 300. Now, obviously, if you had more locations, like if you had 20 locations, could you do 20 if statements? Yes, you could. Are there more efficient ways? Yes, later in the course you learn ways that make this way more efficient to do, right? But we got to do the easier stuff first to get the basics going. So the basic idea here, right? Find the random number and you decide on three things to do. OK, Okay, it's only going to do one of them because they all have different values of num. Let's give it a go, remembering it's the left click on the player that makes this happen. Click, click. Now sometimes it chooses the spot he's already in. So if you think it's not working, it is always working. Okay, not bad. Now one last one I want to do here is when the arrow hits the wall, decide what kind of explosion to make. Do you want to make an explosion or make a ring type of explosion effect? So let's go to the wall, being hit by the arrow. You can see here that we already have a little bit of code, always making the ring. What I can change here, and you're probably getting the hang of this now, is I want to make a decision, right? Choose what to do. So I can say if, well, before I do my if, I better make a variable. So let's find a variable here, num, I random range. This time I'm going to find a value between 1 and 100, just to make a point. And I'm going to say if the number is less than 30, we make the ring. If the number is greater or equal to 30, I'm going to make the explosion. Actually, let's see what else we have here. Usually this would auto-complete for me. Oh, well. We'll go for the explosion. X, Y, 0, C, I don't know, blue explosion. The reason I did this one with the 1 to 100 is this is one way you can set the odds of something happening. If you don't want the odds to be 50-50, pick a bigger number. Like 1 to 100 is nice. There's a 30% chance it'll be under 30. Maybe that's a 29% chance, but it's pretty close to a 30% chance. And then a 70% chance it's going to be 30 or larger. Probably actually 71. But this sort of shows you how you can split the odds here. We should be getting the explosion more often than the ring. So let's give this a go. So we do seem to be getting the explosion more often with the arrows. Remember, we just coded that with the arrows. So that's a nice little example of doing odds. Okay, you're going to be given a few challenges to do. Continuing on this file. Good luck with those, and of course, there'll be a solution video for you if you have any trouble with those. And then we'll see you in the next lesson.